Trailblazers. My name is Narin and let's dive into the lore and secrets of Honkai Star Rail. With Ruan Mace Banner back, I want to take this opportunity to discuss some interesting and maybe slightly disturbing facts about her. Another reason is because I find Ruan Mace holds many secrets behind her emotionless and calm appearance. So sit tight and let's get into it. Ruan Mace comes from a planet covered in ice and snow called No Man's Land. Interestingly, in Honkai Impact III, specifically in the Lightbone Arc, a place named No Man's Land is also mentioned, although it isn't clear if these two places refer to the same location. Another interesting detail is that her homeworld is a planet blessed by abundance. In the Ruan Mace PV, we see a red-eyed monster whose eyes closely resemble blades. Moreover, a similar symbol appears in the Abundance Lightcon, where followers of Abundance worship it. This suggests that the monster seen by Ruan Mace is a denizen of Abundance. Ruan Mace's homeworld is No Man's Land, but it is likely that her parents and family are from Xianzhou. Herta once mentioned wanting to learn more about Xianzhou, but had limited information, so she planned to ask Ruan Mace for more details. I mean, I think at first glance, we can clearly see that Ruan Mace is connected to Xianzhou. Her clothing, as well as her hobbies of enjoying traditional theater and embroidery are deeply rooted in Xianzhou culture. So, even though Ruan Mace grew up on No Man's Land, she remains closely connected to Xianzhou culture and knows a lot about it. This also explains why Ruan Mace and her family live on No Man's Land, a planet blessed by abundance. As mentioned in her character story, Ruan Mace's mother is a scientist, and their family are science enthusiasts. They might intentionally settle in No Man's Land to investigate the denizens of abundance. Since Ruan Mace's family is from Xianzhou, it is highly likely that they, and of course Ruan Mace, are long-life species. As mentioned in her Lightcon, past self in mirror, her reflection appears untouched by time, meaning she still looks young despite the passage of time. As we know, the people of Xianzhou stop aging at a certain point, and will look the same even after hundreds of years. If the theory that she is a long-life species is wrong, it is likely that as an expert in life science, she made herself stop aging. In Ruan Mace's character story, it is mentioned that both her parents have passed away. So, how could she receive a letter from her mother at the beginning of her PV? It turns out that when Ruan Mace's parents died, she couldn't accept it. Moreover, it seems her parents' deaths were caused by an unexpected event. As Ruan Mace mentioned, she failed to keep her promise to protect them. Since then, she began questioning the purpose of creating living beings if they are destined to die. All living beings will eventually let others down, but science never does. So, Ruan Mace began nurturing replicas of her parents using data. With patience and care, she continued to nurture her parents until she finally succeeded in bringing them back to life. Although made of data, her parents behave like real humans. As shown at the beginning of the PV, her mother could even send letters to Ruan Mace. With science, Ruan Mace succeeded in bringing back her parents, and with science, they will never live again. Her parents will never let her down again. Although Ruan Mace's parents have passed away, she actually still has a grandmother. However, her grandmother disappeared after joining the Intelligentsia Guild. But surprisingly, Ruan Mace's grandmother has been secretly watching over her. In her fourth character story, it is mentioned that Ruan Mace's grandmother has been monitoring her through a screen, day after day, for countless years without Ruan Mace knowing. Honestly, I find it quite creepy and disturbing. I feel that Ruan Mei still holds many mysteries, especially since she said that she wants to be an Aeon. Hopefully, we will get more content about her in the future updates. Alright, I think that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy it, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe for more Honkai Star Rail lore and secrets. See you at the next stop!